Unemployed.
You see this street here? James Turner Street was one of the best streets.
Unemployed.
No, one of the worst.
James Turner Street in Birmingham is not your average street. There are 99 houses, 13 nationalities, and most of the residents are claiming benefits.
Probably 5% of the people on this road that are working.
But times are getting tougher.
Your housing benefit is going to get cut. What kind of nonsense is that?
They're having to learn to get by on less.
How are we supposed to live on £50 a week?
And rely on each other more.
If the council won't come and pick it up, we'll do it ourselves.
Fun guy!
It's mad. It's just like one great big family.
Is there any point?
Don't talk to me.
Is there any point?
Do not talk
is there any point?
To me.
I don't think you could ever meet anything any more dysfunctional.
Over the course of a year,
I'm pregnant and off my head.
Through good times and bad.
Move on!
Life on James Turner Street.
I've never lived without my kids, ever.
Would be challenged like never before.
It's not all about money. You could have all the money in the world and have nothing compared to what we've got around here.
That's a road!
See you later. Don't know how long it's going to be.
Mark's a father of two who's never had a paid job. It's lunchtime and he's off to an appointment at the job centre. His fiancée Becky is left with Casey and Callum, who's missed nursery again.
You know who wrote to me today? Do you know who sent Mummy a letter? Your school.
Me not afraid of Kuwell. Me not going to nursery.
Why?
Because.
Many of the parents on James Turner Street are on benefits.
Welcome to the no-job world.
Oh, you...
Mark and Becky are having money problems.
I just dropped my 50p.
They've already been caught claiming too much benefits in the past. Now their rent hasn't been paid and they're £3,000 in debt.
It all started when we split up in December. And when I moved back in, she phoned up and went to put my name back down. They couldn't do it.
It's about time you like, take a step in our shoe and see how it is living on benefits.
On James Turner Street, kids are everywhere. Many are raised by single parents.
That's really naughty, isn't it?
Despite their ups and downs, Becky and Mark are still together. And around here, that's not always a given.
If you throw that, I will smack your hand.
Idiots. Kid, crap about that. You've got to get your partner to phone. Because I cannot discuss nothing with you. Oh, wish I'd have bothered.
Becky and Mark are learning how to cope with kids. When it's not been long since they left school themselves.
On the Friday the 13th, we actually both got together. Now, she told me a couple of weeks after that I was a bet, that her and her friend was betting on me to see who could win me first. And obviously, it was Becky.
Don't kick it hard. Mark, you keep on hitting up poor Casey's head. He didn't actually ask me out. He just says, are we, And I was like, well, what does mean? And then we actually went back to our last registration of the day. And then a letter flew across the table. Will you go out with me?
Says a lot about me, don't it?
Now, that's why I say all the time, no football in the house.
Across the road, Gerard lives with his sister and his mum, White D.
I am the mum of the streets. Who are them? Your woman had the nerve to wave at me today, the one that I had to go at the other day. We've got, you know, the young parents, the young kids and single parents.
ex-drug addicts or drug addicts. It's like one great big family.
Dee's own family is missing a man. She split from her long-term partner when Caitlin was three.
Would you not even like one picture of your dad?
No.
I didn't just meet him and then fucking boom, I was with him for 12 years, babes. Do you know what I'm saying? So, bound to have photos of him. Wonder what happened to that picture that I took of you. Remember your first ever poo in Ireland? Oh, there it is. Oh, she was such a cutie, weren't she? Then you had to grow up.
Without work in the morning, some on the street stay up all night.
Beat that blood.
It's gone midnight, and three-year-old Callum isn't ready for bed.
That's it. Stop, stop. How about we skip the sugar, and then your teeth won't get bad? Okay, tiniest bit.
Stan!
Okay, then let go of the sugar bar.
You
know what the time is?
Yeah.
12:20.
I'm not going to your bed anymore.
Why? I've realised I hate your bed.
I think you was born in a different life. You was a child on GMT video of morning. He died, but he came back as another person. Yeah. And he could tell you everything, what happened. I think it was World War One.
Me and Fungi were talking earlier and he was on about it could be an imaginary friend. And I was like, well, he's already killed one. Because he had a friend, but he didn't like him, so we killed him with the brush.
Make sure there's no cars coming.
Benefits are paid at midnight, and for the desperate, that means a late-night trip to the cash point.
Thank you very much.
Sam's a mother of two, who started doing this journey when she got hooked on heroin and crack. She's trying to get clean so she can see her kids again.
Any ID on you?
I'm 28. The only thing I've got is photo ID from the prison card.
But old habits die hard, and temptation lurks around every corner.
I have thought, no. Right now, I have thought about getting drugs. My head says yes, and my heart says no. I feel a bit like, shall I, shan't I, shall I, shan't I? But I'm definitely not.
Callum, if I find out you're in the window, I'm gonna smack you. Because it's dangerous.
What is this?
Is that he does, he opens the window and tries to climb out. That's not funny, that's dangerous. If you don't in that window, I will smack you.
It's 20-1, and Callum's woken up his little sister, Casey.
You better stop, I'm going to put Casey back to bed.
Do not move! It's not, I'll just sit here, it don't bother me.
So sweet. Thank you, Lord, for the things you eat. Thank you, Lord, for the birds that see. Thank you, Lord, for everything. Amen.
It's 8:30 a.m. For those who have a job, it's time to go to work. Callum called it a night around 5 this morning. Now Becky is trying to get him ready for nursery.
Seriously, can't wear your vest like that.
I believe that there's a ghost in the house, and the only one he can see is Callum. He couldn't be telling him to do certain things, you know what I mean?
Fungi's a father of three. He doesn't get to see his own kids, but he and Callum are close.
We had a ghost years ago. He was a drummer boy. We had to get a priest in to bless the house, and he left.
I'd been friends with Gerard's dad for over 20 years. Never had no romantic inklings whatsoever.
Safe.
Safe. We went out one night, got absolutely wasted. Bang. Gerard, that's when I gave up drinking.
One advantage of being a single mum was that Dee could name her son after whoever she wanted.
This one is going to buy me a house when he's older. Not put me in a home. This one will put me in a home.
You belong in the home.
Love ya. Please behave yourself.
Son, I ain't got the strength to deal with ya.
Callum's still refusing to get dressed, and Mark and Becky are running out of ideas.
Night's all right, love.
Punishment porch come from because he keeps on climbing over this stair gate now. What he does, he stands on there and just jumps over. So then this is the safest way. He can't get out the front door and he can't get in here because of the stair gate. So I suppose it's better.
Becky and Mark missed a doctor's appointment for Callum, and now a team of health visitors are on their case.
The appointment he actually missed, he had chicken pox. So now the doctors are putting it down to neglect.
3 minutes.
The worst case scenario could be where they end up removing Callum and Casey from us. I'm just touching wood, nothing will be like that.
This is a street where many kids are raised by single parents.
Fuck you two!
Mark and Becky are one of the few couples trying to make a go of it together.
Come on.
What's going on there, then? Sweary.
He's a twat. Your fella's a twat. He's a knob. I don't hate him, he's just a knob.
He has his days.
If he knocks my door, he won't knock my door.
No, because he's got Callum Case.
No, we won't knock the door, because I'll fucking batter shit out of him. How many fucking cookers on nearly gassed us to death?
Shall we open a window, because I got a cigarette on? We would have gone up by now.
It's a big stress on us, Callum is. Like, him playing up. And then I say one thing, and then she does the next thing. And there's no communication between us both. His bedroom was nice and tidy until I've got all this cubby all out. And start to sort it out.
Do you want a cup of tea?
Yes, please. So I had to go tell me to fuck myself.
Because you was annoying me.
How? Tell me how.
The thing that tripped me up is Callum.
Exactly, so why have I got me over it?
I didn't have a go at you.
Yes, you did.
All right, then I'm sorry for having a go at you. Is that okay? You know you love me. No. Nor that. Me and Mark were, like, just friends to start off with, and then, like, we kind of got into a relationship. But, when I first met Mark, I was on drugs. I tried heroin. That nearly killed me. But then we had a party and ended up taking a bit of crack and stuff. And I'm glad, like, Mark was the one to turn around and say to my face basically how it was. He's like, well, you're going to kill yourself going through this. And you're going to do this and then you're going to end up with no money, no life. But I suppose them words had to be said, otherwise I wouldn't have been here now. Guarantee it.
No one stepped in to save Sam when she started dabbling with drugs. And in the end, it cost her her kids.
I wrote this letter to my son's nan. I just wanted to explain a few things about my life from the day I was told I have depression and also taking drugs, heroin. Me and Junior, your son, had split up. I started drinking and taking drugs, and that's when Tyrell came to live with you. I found it hard to cope, and I turned to crime, which resulted in me going to jail twice. Now is the right time for me to start sorting contact with Tyrell out. I really miss him so much and can't wait to see him and you on a regular basis. That's it.
What's that?
There's a barbecue taking place on the street, but White D's daughter Caitlin is hiding out in the park at the end of the road.
She's told Tejan to suck his mum. Oh, now where is she?
Hello? Not impressed, you know, D. Who's picking is she telling to go suck their mother? She's like, got no manners.
And she said that.
Me and you, right, have never had any qualms, but D.
No, no, babes.
For your picnic, we're going to have qualms because she don't tell my son to suck his mother.
Excuse me, lad.
Caitlin, right, I just said to her what's happened outside. She says she don't know. Tejan come to her and says, you want her.
I've been putting her middle finger up at Renee and telling her about, don't act like you're bad. Is that about it? Go on, suck me.
Suck yourself and all this shit. It's just stupidness. Well, I'm going for my shower.
Love is all around me, so let the feeling grow.
It's been exactly 5 years since Mark asked Becky out at school. But it's an important date for another reason.
How far is Tehran off it from the first year?
Oh, no.
Morning, guys.
Morning.
Lovely, ain't it?
Never mind. Don't put a downer on that day, does he?
No.
Good.
The health visitors want to check on Callum after he missed a doctor's appointment.
Do you know what's happening today?
Yeah.
Mummy and Daddy been together for 5 years today. And we've got health visitor coming.
In Becky's life, officials usually mean stress, so she's on her guard.
Mark's never kind of, like, really been, like, in with social services and stuff before.
Right, scrubby-scrub.
Family members of mine have been. So I understand, like, these people don't come out just for no reason. They're coming out for a reason every time. They're going to think we can't cope with Callum.
Hello. You OK? Yes, thank you.
Health visitors are part of the NHS, but they also share information with social services.
Okay. Hello, Callum.
Hi.
Hello.
Come say hello.
So are you OK, Callum?
There's, like, no really major concerns, like, with, like, their health and stuff. It's just Callum's behaviour.
When he has one of his tantrums or behaviour problems, it's like you can't tell him off. He'll scream, shout, throw stuff.
It's like if I was to say no, he'd just physically come up and hit me because I've said no.
And what are you doing with
and
that?
And then I tell him, no, you can't hit me, and I do put him in the porch.
You put him in there?
For 3 minutes. Instead of the naughty step, we put him in the porch.
And is it working or not?
To tell you the truth, he can be in there, like, 6 to 7 times a day.
Well, someone somewhere's reported them. They don't just turn up. Do you know what I mean? You can't become a perfect parent by reading one of these books that these health visitors hand you and stuff. Half these health visitors haven't got kids themselves anyway. Oh, shit! The doctors.
I think that went all right, though, ain't it, with her?
Yeah, not too bad.
But didn't it feel like she was trying to tell you, like, you're not doing a good enough job with the behaviour bit with him?
Yeah, when, especially when we told her about the porch.
Did you see her?
Sat here when...
She looked devastated.
Penny for the poor.
After seeing Mark and Becky in action, the health visitors have suggested they take parenting classes.
May I borrow your laptop, please, dear?
For?
Parenting classes.
So you're going to use my laptop inside your house?
Right, the one to do it on the sofa. Or we could come sit on your doorstep.
Nah, you're all right.
Callum can tell Roger.
Fuck off.
Being really careful. Don't want to drop it.
You just go on to parenting classes by Winston Green.
Winston Green. HM Prison. I'll put in hands.
No, just put hands on.
Becky, get that off.
Sorry.
Sam's still doing her best to spend her benefits on food rather than drugs.
No way, 75.
And she's still hoping to see her son.
Hello, can you hear me? Hello, Veronica, it's Sam. You all right? How's Tyrell? Is he? Is it still possible for us to meet up and have a chat, please?
I'll have to check my diary just for what I'm doing, because at the moment I'm doing something else.
But, it's nice to speak to you anyway. How are ya? She just put the phone down. Last time I had him, I ended up getting arrested. So, because I had him for the weekend, and I went out, and while I was out, I ended up getting arrested. I had my son in my care, and I ended up going to jail for breaching probation.
Kids learn a lot about life from the grown-ups of James Turner Street. Today, Fungi is entertaining his drinking buddies. And it clashes with an important day for Mark and Becky.
Becky, he wants you to do it.
No, he has to learn. Daddy's dressing him.
Becky! Yeah? It's not working.
They're expecting their first visit from a SureStart advisor who's here to help them cope with their kids.
I know she's here for your behaviours, but could you try and be best behaved?
So we've got in there, yeah? Battered him with a chair leg, and then he's come out onto the street, it was pitch black. He had no lights in his house either. And then as he was standing underneath the street light, not he's got a knife about that big proper kitchen knife. Then looked at me arm. He stabbed me about.
Should we go inside?
Oh,
okay?
Yeah. I take it to heart, mate. Look at this scar, yeah. Got stabbed there, yeah, straight from my lung. Nearly died, mate.
Do you generally kind of sit outside with the children? And...
not all the time,
though. Okay, sometimes exposing children to that type of environment does influence them as well, doesn't it?
Yeah, that one's great. That one's great. Yeah, fuck off, you mic shit.
So, because he's four now, we do want to get him off the dummy. What do you think?
We have been, like, yeah, just recently, we're only trying to get him onto it. Only on a night, if it can be helped.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, when he's playing outside with his friends,
mm-hmm,
depending on, like, the friends he's playing with. Mm-hmm.
So he goes and plays outside with the children?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Like, he has everyone on the street, you know.
OK. Obviously, with children's behaviour, there's a cause of behaviour. There's always a trigger, isn't there? And that's what we have to look at, what is the cause. And it could be the family environment, it could be the outside environment. He has peers, like we said, he's got friends that are older. What I can do is come to the house, observe Callum, you know, you parenting Callum, and then we can start making a plan together as a team, yeah?
Yeah, that's fine.
Fucking Blue Army. You're blue. You're like, you fucking dying. Yeah, I do.
White D's son, Gerard, has spent the whole 5 years of his life on James Turner Street.
I think he's more streetwise than his sister, and that's scary.
No, links and things like that.
Yeah.
What do you do? You spray that, and you put your light underneath it.
He knows way too much for a five-year-old. You know what I mean? And that's just from being riding up and down the road on his bike.
I've got to see my kids as well, and you've done that to me.
How often do you see your kids?
Look at that. I'm seeing them later.
Well, how often do you see your kids?
It doesn't make a difference.
Yeah, it fucking does. I even go there, Pshad.
He'll know what a cigarette is. He knows what a spliff is. He's gone from, like, calling it broccoli. He used to think it was broccoli at first.
Yeah, I can still get that, man. Will you smoke it, Blue?
All right, man. Twos, yeah.
What, you think you're going to get twos off me now?
I have thought, what is there for him? Is it destined that he'll just grow up and he'll be part of a gang? Because that's society, isn't it?
And basically, I didn't realise that rent had got fallen behind because the estate agents didn't notify me until, obviously, the arrears built up to the amount they've got to now.
6 months ago, Mark and Becky had a temporary split and it caused a problem with their housing benefit.
Mark, now make a note of 895.
895?
Oh, sorry, £845.
845.
And 95 pence. And just remember, for the year...
195.
Yeah, 845. We pay £500 per cadmium a month.
They owe the landlord over £3,000, but their income for the whole family is only £255 per week.
No, he's a full-time dad as well. We're just a bit worried about being evicted as well.
New benefit rules are having a big impact on the street. White D's employment support allowance has been frozen.
Timing's absolutely shit. I've got two fucking school uniforms to buy now in what? When they go back, 3rd of August? I think personally to think it's all to do with stats, because I'm officially classed as...
Old infection?
You know, not claiming now, am I?
Why, because are you an old age pensioner?
No, I'm not an old age pensioner. I'm just fucking skint. Nothing to do with fucking age. Do you want another smack? Because you had a smack last night.
Caitlin done it.
Dee's neighbour Titch can't find a job and is thinking of starting his own business, collecting scrap.
These women, they breed to make money from the government.
Yeah.
They want to breed because they know they get a house. In Africa, if you don't work, you don't eat. But here, men, they sleep, look after the kids. The country is not going to be afford to pay for everybody. We have to work.
Today, the church at the end of the road is running a job club.
Come on, before they start, and you miss all the introductions.
Is there any introduction?
There is.
No, there's not.
There is. Come on. It's about you supporting your family.
Listen. Thousands and thousands of people done. Getting laid off work. What chance have I got of going into a job? He sees my CV, not many qualifications. He sees the next man's with, like, a load less degrees, education, everything. Who's going to be more interesting?
Yeah, it's for us, Mark, and you have to show the kids that you want to provide for them.
Oh, cheer up, Becky. Like the man said, if your head's down, then... You got always keep your head high. No matter what life brings to you, no matter what life throws at you, you got to keep your head high.
Present yourself well, won't you?
Maths, English, science.
M-A-T-H-S.
Where do I write that?
It's in the right place.
Mark's only had a few unpaid jobs since he left school 4 years ago, so he's starting his CV from scratch.
Tap, tap, tap. Yeah. And you're saying the other one is B-Tech, yeah?
Yeah, B-Tech.
Right, B-Tech. In caps, caps, caps.
Oh.
What else? Quick.
I tried to say. Yes.
Hey, fingers. Ah. Get what's in here on your fingers.
Football.
Okay, leave this section for now, yeah? Have you done any other kind of anything?
Nah.
Never?
Never.
So what you been doing with your time since 2008? That's what, if you went for an interview, that's what they're going to ask you. What have you been doing with your time?
Looking for work and...
Just like me?
Yeah, just looking.
Did you know I'm not working as well? I'm a volunteer.
Nah.
I'm not working. I'm looking for work as well.
Wow.
Okay. This is the bare bones on a CV.
Yeah.
You need to put some meat on this.
Yeah.
I'm fucking telling you, I've never met no one like Mark in all my fucking life. He's great. and I love him to bits now, Beck. I'm not gonna lie, but I told him when I first met him, fuck's sake, you got two kids, he's a fucking young, you get me? So on the other hand, you've got to give yourself credit, you get me? Car, you get couples out there that can't manage two kids, Beck, you get me? And like, you're young and you're doing it, so like, give yourself credit. If you can get a job and better yourself, fair play, but you can't be stressing yourselves out and you got kids in it, like, why the kids are still young? I say you claim your fucking benefits, that's what I fucking say. When the kids get a bit older, then you look for work.
Bare bones, I've a CV.
But your date of birth's not on here.
No, he's gonna add it all.
Interests, I enjoy playing football, walking, swimming, and social losing with my friends and family. I think it's supposed to be socialising, isn't it?
Started something new, though, Dave.
Yeah, I know, I agree.
I've got to start doing something.
I agree. God bless him. Small things, though.
Guess what Daddy's got on? You're not gonna know what it is. Huh? You know what that is? Huh? When Daddy's finished, be able to go out and work. That what you want? Daddy go and work.
Taking that in the house, because there's one thing you always keep on doing, both of you, putting it on the floor and just leaving it to melt. Yeah. But you're doing it sneakily that I can't even see where you're putting it, so no ice lolly in the house.
Even with help from the church, Mark hasn't found a job. And with the red letters piling up, Becky has had enough.
I'm gonna go mad on him, because he doesn't do hardly anything and he just thinks everything's a joke.
So what have I done then, Becky?
What haven't you done?
Becky, you can't keep treating me like a dickhead.
A dickhead, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, OK.
Job, Becky, you need to grow up.
Well, I think you should go find a job. Mommy, instead of sitting at home.
What is the point of love? What is the meaning of love? What is the deep meaning of love?
I don't know, you tell me.
You tell me.
You're Becky. Hungry, what do you want? Boxes. OK.
Becky.
What?
Shut your fucking mouth, shouting.
You know what, go fuck yourself, don't talk to me.
Is there any point?
Don't talk to me.
Is there any point?
Do not talk
is there any point?
To me.
Is there any point?
Don't talk to me.
Is there any point?
Bastard, cut me off.
What are you trying to do?
A fucking prescription.
What for?
For tablets.
What are the tablets for?
For me to take. Antidepressants. Not many people know I'm on tablets, you know, fucking happy pills. That's probably why I'm happy. I ain't happy if I don't take them. What do you want? You can't go to the toilet. There's no ball in the bathroom, Gerard. You left it out on the road, so someone's probably stolen it. A shower?
Mum, calm down. The doctor said no stressing.
Like you says to me, whenever I'm going to the shop and I don't want to advertise my phone because I don't want to get mugged. I don't want to get mugged, so I'm cutting off my phone because I'm by Foundry. Let me turn my phone off.
Can't stand the bullshit no longer. Are you serious? I'm leaving. Try to sleep at my mate's house somewhere.
On the doorstep.
My stuff's on doorstep and watch. Becky.
Whatever.
I've just been thinking about everything since I've been sitting out here, thinking how I want my life to plan out and what else can I do to make it better. But no answers, yeah. I just feel like pissed off sometimes, but I don't. I stick around because the kids and Becky. Mm.
love is just like a flower. The flower grows and grows. You get the bud, then you get the petals. And at the end, all falls off and dies.
I think half our petals have fallen off. It'll be like another flower. If we can sort everything out, it'll be like a new flower growing back. But if we can't, then it's just gonna, die, really.
I like doing skids as well, so I might do a little performance.
Can't fucking smoke when I'm asleep.
Jay, come here.
Jay.
No. Jay. No. One more.
Mum of the street, White D, has had the ESA benefits she receives for her depression frozen.
That wasn't proper.
Yes, it was.
It wasn't.
And the family are now £106 a week worse off.
Is you're part of our problem? You kids.
Okay.
Stress me out.
Okay.
Mark's finally got a job for an agency that gets people to donate to charity. He's on 100% commission, so it all relies on the success of his sales pitch.
Hi there, I'm not as bad as I look. We look after all your local diabetes.
Pardon?
We look after all your local diabetes in the community.
Yeah.
What we need to try and do, we need to try and raise £1 million. But yeah. Don't worry, I couldn't say how, so you can't run nothing like that.
I'm not donating now.
Hi there, don't look as bad as I am. This is just a call back from earlier.
Oh, sorry. Don't do anything at all.
Thank you very much. Do you know anyone who's diabetes?
No.
You're very lucky. Touch wood, I hope it stays that way. What we're trying to do, we're trying to raise £1 million. But don't worry, I'm not selling your house or nothing like that.
Self-employed, I've got no work whatsoever.
Okay, then.
Sausage?
I'm not buying sausage.
And
sweets, okay.
With the promise of a wage coming into the street, Becky can buy food.
No, Callum!
Without Mark, she has Callum and Casey to herself.
Now, do you want to go in there? Are you going to behave? Or I'll take you in there. So when you're round the corner from home, come away from the road. That's where Daddy goes. And look, there's another man coming upon his bike. At this moment in time, him working hasn't really sunk in. Just hasn't really sunk in.
Mark's job is yet to earn him a penny, and it's almost 10 o'clock by the time he gets home.
I did it. He's asleep. Very quiet. Case is awake.
Quiet, Cora.
Do you mean
what
you
fucking call? Twat?
I put time and effort into that.
Luna, watch, don't get your damn shot.
Come on!
With or without work, there are always appointments that need to be kept.
See you later. Wish me luck.
Good luck.
Thank you. See you later.
Before traveling, for this
methadone, yeah.
But on the street, rush hour begins when the school day ends.
Got anything you want to say? No. It was an accident. He was playing with a rock near a window.
Dee's already down over £100 a week, and fixing the window will eat into what's left.
You've been home, what, an hour? You've caught his fingers in the door.
That weren't my fault.
You've thrown a strop. He's broke a window in an hour.
Mm-hmm.
we have to be so calm tonight with him.
Just see how.
Oh, that looks really relaxing, actually.
Let me just go and get him a teddy.
No, let him choose a teddy.
Cow!
No, he's eating.
Nothing to write.
Mark still hasn't earned a penny from his job, but Becky's been working on Callum, and she's determined to get him to bed on time.
Not that one. He don't like that one, because it's funny fur, but this one's soft.
Run, Nana, give kiss. Run, Nana, baby. Do you want to move over a little bit?
He doesn't need anything or want anything. Leave him now.
You're a fucking big mouth. Listen. You're a big mouth.
Listen.
I said about the phone, just lie him down.
Listen, have you not realised something? Because I just learnt that. Casey's following Callum's negative behaviour. So we just have to ignore her as well at the moment.
Don't get tired, the face,
Callum,
will
it? Just say goodnight to Casey.
Nana!
No, not to... I don't want him to know we're listening. Callum just said goodnight to Casey. Don't reply.
Where's your bike?
Up there.
Up where?
Everywhere.
No, it's there. I can't see it.
Gerard was playing out on his bike, but he's come home on foot.
Where is your bike?
The bike was a birthday present, and now it's missing.
Where's your bike? Answer me the question!
Mum, I've gone, Pa.
Did you take your bike out today? You're going to get into more trouble for not answering my question. Go find it. Fucking pisses me off
when
he doesn't answer the fucking question.
Got it. You left
that
at the bar.
Stupid idiot, you're grounded.
The doctor said that she's really not well. Like, Mum's gonna need a bit of time to herself. But I know she's gonna get better because the doctor did say she's gonna get worse before she gets better. But I don't know what that means. But even though it might take a long time, I know she's gonna get better.
We're gonna lie down now.
And we're gonna count sheep.
One sheep.
Two sheep. Three sheep. Four sheep.
Three. I'm going to sleep.
I love how quiet it is. High five.
Becky made me a pizza.
Excuse me. It ain't that bad. People in Africa would pay me for that kind of food. You still eat it? I'm gonna eat it.
Do you want a happy meal?
Yeah. Successful night.
I thought you said sexful night. Successful.
Yeah.
Say it.
Say what?
Perfection isn't all flipping, gleaming white and this, that and the other.
Do it. One king, two king, three king.
Four king.
Perfection is seeing your kids happy.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Casey.
Social services have died off. And I don't want them to really be involved any day soon.
Hip hip!
Hello.
We've been through so much. If we can get through all that, we can get through anything.
What's happened to your job then, Mum?
I just quit it.
How much did you earn?
Fuck all.
Didn't earn a penny.
It was just a fucking nightmare.
I'll give you contact details.
I'm stupid. I can't work, man. I'm too old, man. I'm an alcoholic. Bloody drug addict.
You really just want to get a job?
Yes.
And be completely different to the rest of the world.
Yes.
Fucking hell.
I don't want to be broke and look broke. Or look poor.
takeout.
I just don't want my kids to have the life that I had.
$2.99, please.
I'm not going to say I'm too old to have dreams, because I'm not too old to have dreams.
I must be the unluckiest guy on the planet.
I've had enough. I'd like to know what it's like not to be normal. But I want to get to know my kids.
Fun guy, you're going to meet your son in a few minutes.
Support for the issues raised can be found at channel4.com/support. Coming up, the wait may have gone, but for some this leaves a new problem. My baggy body meets those desperate to shed their extra skin.